Dear friend, welcome to the video lecture. In this video lecture, you will be able to learn to derive and define the electric potential or potential difference, derive the potential difference equation, derive Maxwell's equations for electrostatic fields, and you can establish the relationship between electric field intensity E and the potential V. Now, coming to the definition of electric potential or potential difference, the potential at any point is the potential difference between that point and a chosen reference point. It is also defined as the work done to bring a unit charge from infinity to the specified point in presence of the electric field. So we can write P as a ratio of work done to bring that unit charge Q from the reference point to the specified point. And the units will be volts or joules per coulomb. Now we try to derive the electric potential or potential difference expression. So let us consider we have the electric field here. This is the electric field. In this electric field, we just wanted to move a unit charge Q from point A to point B. So any point in the space will be referenced by the origin. So we will be having the origin O here. And the distance between point A and our origin is RA, and the distance between the origin O and the point B is RB. Suppose we wish to move the point charge Q up to a distance of dl bar, then the differential work done dw can be written as minus of a bar dot dl bar. Now the charge Q is moved just this much of distance dl bar. Now from this point to the origin, we can say the distance as r. So to move this much of distance dl bar, then the differential work done is dw equal to minus of a bar dot dl bar. So once we move the charge from one point to other point in presence of electric field, then the charge will experience a Coulomb force. So that the Coulomb force experienced by the charge is given by F bar equal to Q E bar. So I can write dW equal to minus of Q E bar dot dL bar. Now, if I want to calculate the total work done to move that point charge Q from point A to point B as shown in the figure, then I should integrate on both sides. So the total work done I get as W equal to minus of integration A to B Q E bar dot dl bar. Now here I bring this Q towards the left side in the denominator, then W by Q equal to minus of point A to point B, then it is E bar dot dl bar. Now, as per the definition that I know, the work done to bring a unit charge from infinity to a specified point in presence of the electric field, I call that one as potential or potential difference, so that I can write VAB equal to integration A to point A to point B, then E bar dot dl bar. I can also write this one as VAB equal to minus of RA to RB, and the electric field for a unit charge is given by Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square AR bar, then dot DL bar can be written as DR AR bar. Now the dot product between two similar unit vectors will be always one, so I can write VAB equal to minus of RA to RB Q by 4 pi epsilon naught R square dr. Now VAB equal to minus of Q is constant, 4 pi epsilon naught is also constant, and the integration takes RA to RB 1 by R square dr. So in this case I can write Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, then integration RA to RB r power minus 2 dr. So it is minus of Q by 4 pi epsilon naught, then it is r power minus 2 plus 1 by minus 2 plus 1, and the limits will take from Ra to Rb. Now Vab equal to minus of q by 4 pi epsilon naught, then it is 1 by r, that we get as r power minus 1, minus of r power minus 1. So here we get minus, and it is Ra to Rb. So Vab equal to, here we have minus and minus, so you can write q by 4 pi epsilon naught, where 1 by r will take the limits Ra to Rb now. So Vab equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught, then it is 1 by Rb minus 1 by Ra, where I can write this one as individually to point B and point A as q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught Ra. So Vab equal to, now this is the potential at point B, so I will write this one as Vb, and this is the potential at point A, I can write Va. Now this Vab is the potential difference between the point B and point A in the presence of electric field, and Vb is the absolute potential at point B, and Va is the absolute potential at point A. Now generally the reference point that we consider is at infinity. So here we have chosen two points, point A and point B, in presence of the electric field. So in that case, if we choose this point A is at infinity, that means Ra is towards infinity. So in that case, Vab equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught Ra. Now this Ra tends to infinity, so that q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught infinity. Now this entire term becomes zero, so I can write this one as q by 4 pi epsilon naught Rb, which is equal to Vab. So in sense, it is the absolute potential at point B, and generally I can write this one as V equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught R, and the units for this potential is volts. So this is the way of deriving the potential difference and potential electric potential expression. Now in integral form, we can also write this potential as V equal to minus of line integral, which to bring the unit charge from infinity to the specified point, any point which is at the distance of r, E bar dot dl bar, that we can write. Now this is the expression that a point which is at the origin, if the point is at different locations. So in that case, what we can do is we can write V R equal to q by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R dash. If say it is R dash, then we can write R minus R dash. Now if there are n number of points, then we can write this one as V of R equal to q1 by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R1 plus q2 by 4 pi epsilon naught R minus R2, so on. That means the superposition principle can also be applicable to the electric potential or electric potential difference. Now we would like to derive the Maxwell's equation from the electric potential E. So here we know that VBA is equal to minus of VAB, and VBA plus VAB equal to integration of, that is closed line integral of e bar dot dl bar. This means that previously we have the electric field, and in that electric field we just moved a point charge q from point A to point B in presence of the electric field. Now what we are going to do after that, we are again moving that point charge towards A in the opposite direction. So in that case, the total potential difference will be coming zero. Now depending on the closed line integral of E bar dot dl bar, which is equal to zero. Now this is one of the Maxwell's equation for electrostatic fields, and it is in integral form. Now by applying Stokes' theorem, just we are applying the Stokes' theorem, then the closed line integral of E bar dot dl bar will be just converted into open surface integral of curl of that vector E bar then ds bar, which is equal to zero. So in this case I can write del cross E bar equal to zero. So here we can say that the electric field is irrotational, and we can also call this expression as conservative in nature. The electric field is conservative in nature. So we call this one as Maxwell's second equation in point form. So we have one Maxwell's equations from electric potential or potential difference for electrostatic fields. Now we would like to see the relationship between electric field intensity and electric potential, right? So we know that the electric field and electric potentials in generally are given with V equal to minus of integral E bar dot dl bar. This is the general representation of the electric potential and electric field intensity. Now if we can also write this expression as dv equal to minus of E bar dot dl bar, and we are writing this entire expression in terms of Cartesian coordinate system, and according to calculus of multivariables we can write dv as dou v by dou x dx plus dou v by dou y dy plus dou v by dou z dz. So according to calculus of multivariables, dv can be written as dou v by dou x dx plus dou v by dou y dy plus dou v by dou z dz, which is equal to, now I am also expanding this electric field intensity and dl bar in terms of Cartesian coordinate system as minus of ex ax bar plus ey ay bar plus ez az bar dot dx ax bar plus dy ay bar plus dz az bar. Now the dot product between the similar vectors will be 1 and dissimilar vectors will be 0, and overall we get minus of ex dx minus of ey dy minus of ez dz, which is equal to dou v by dou x dx plus dou v by dou y dy plus dou v by dou z dz. Now comparing on both sides, then we get dou v by dou x equal to minus of ex, dou v by dou y equal to minus of ey, dou v by dou z equal to minus of ez. So overall we can write in terms of vector form as minus of E bar equal to del V, where we can also write this one as E bar equal to minus of del V. So this will be the relationship between the electric field intensity and electric potential or potential difference. Hope you understand this video, what we have derived. If you feel this video lecture is somewhat informative to you, please do like, comment, share, and subscribe my channel for more technical content. Thank you.